What you think Asia is superpower or Asia superpower India or China? What you think? So you can add your
I
point.
think India is a powerful country because it runs for unity and it is enmity with anyone. And maybe India is up in my sides for a country.
Okay, that's great. You start great. So if you want to add more point, that's good. So you still you have 2 3 minutes, so you can speak whatever you want to say. Why you think India will be become a superpower? Any technology wise or anything? What you think what thing make the India superpower? What you think? Technology or something increasing in GDP, what thing can make the so let's give the chance to Sanjeev and he will explain the things and later you will speak. Okay, start Sanjeev.
Thank you, Ranjana, for giving such a opportunity for the expressing the view on the topic Asia superpower, in which the two countries you have the given the topic is India or China. Let me start with the Asia. As we know that the Asia is most populous continent in the world, and it have the too much variety of ethnic groups, and the also culturally very strong, and it also contributes
Join.
many of the old have the very good history also. So I can start with the most powerful countries in the Asia, like China, India, and also the Taiwan, Indonesia, Singapore. Lots of the country in the Asia is also very powerful. So if you compare the two most populous country in the Asia, that is China and India, I think China has the more population. It is approx 140 crore, above 140 crore, but India is still 130 crore. Approx the population of the India and the China are the equal, and both the country has a long history. So if I am talking about the who is more powerful, I think both the countries in future they become powerful. But if I generally compare, the China is growing rate is much higher than compared with the India. But I think China's jo China thinking and its more focus on the expansion theory of the China. But India still wanted to does not want to dominance is neighborhood. But China always apply the theory of dominance over its neighborhoods. So in this regarding, if we take the another point to compare in between the India and China, so one by one I go to one more point I have to discuss, in which the India and the China compare very easily. Firstly, I start with the technology. As we know, in the world, China has proved that it has not much innovative technology, but it has the capacity to build anything, whichever you want to. Either we know that it lots of technology come in the Israel and America, but the real manufacturing is going on the China. Actually, China build everything whatever the human being use, but India still is lack in the technology and also in its manufacturing capacity, because India is in the underdeveloped, and it have the more unskilled levels in the India. India has need to be making the skilled labor so that it also have will be in the manufacturing hub in India in future also. China, another thing is it's focused only on the expansion theory. So it's built a strong army-based power and also lots of the harbors, and it's also increased its connectivity to the Europe and the most part of the world. As we see that China's Road Belt Initiative programs, also it also started the sea linking programs and other space technology program also. The China is more focused on the expansionist theory. It only focus on China want to become a global power, and its journey started also. But the China's theory in the expansion and technology is good, but as a humanitarian, I think China is not good for its population also. So I can conclude over that, like India approaches on the freedom of either expression or the freedom of the movement or the freedom of enjoy the life also. But China totally banned the freedom of the peoples. As you know that in the Xinjiang plant of the Xinjiang province of the China have the Uyghur Muslim peoples. They have not tried to even follow their religion. They live according to the China's theory of living. They have not freedom to even express to the freedom of expression for its politician. I think is my voice is audible or not, please?
Yeah, you are clear. Your voice is clear.
I am saying that in the China, Alibaba founder, we know that they have the big billionaire in the China. But a few days before, he criticized the Chinese people's China, public China countries, some men. So then the Alibaba's founder also get put into the jail. What shows this? It shows only that the freedom of expression in the China is totally banned. This theory of the expansion of the China to becoming a power after taking and snatching all the humanitarian power of the peoples of the China also, and also it's newly dominating countries also. That's make the difference, a big difference between the India and China. China has development, but has no actually freedom of life. But India has a steady development. It's not partially developed, but it tried to be developed slowly. In the future, it will be developed, I know. Along with it is also give its freedom of expression, freedom of life, freedom of to making joining any groups, a lots of the freedom people really feel in India. That's the difference between the India and the China. China, I think in the future, it become a more powerful country, as like this United Nations is now under. But India will be become a spiritual power. Will be become as a guru of the world, I think. But it takes more time for the Indians to compete with the China and the other, but it's not impossible. India maybe have the good new generation that compete the China very fastly. It may be, but it's all about the prediction. I think I have point that India is still growing, but the China is too fast nowadays. Thank you, Ranjana, for giving up.
Thank you. You explain everything very clearly, and I think you will be best to you cover all the portion whatever required in it, and you said very right that China always not done what they promised, and even they are making other country problematic sometime. So let's give the chance to another person, and let's give the chance to Raju. Raju, please unmute yourself and speak on the topic. Raju, am I audible, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Raju, if you are able to hear me, please unmute yourself. Okay, let's give the chance to another person. Yeah, Nizam, if you want to talk on the topic, please unmute yourself. Akash, thanks for joining in this group. If you want to talk on the topic, please unmute yourself and talk on the topic. First topic is Asia superpower, India or China? So what do you think, India is a superpower or China? So what's your perception? Please come on the topic, and if you able to hear me, please unmute yourself and speak on the topic. Why is everybody silence?
Hello.
Yes.
Actually, I want to hear only first. I'm not prepared.
Okay, nobody is. Everybody is. It's just spontaneous. No, just speak on the whatever you think, because here nobody is judging you. Just giving us. We are giving a platform where people can speak. Not matter what you are speaking. Just you speak what you think, what you felt.
Topic actually can
let me give again in chat section you can find. Let me, yeah, I shared.
Of course China superpower, it's a superpower.
So you okay continue.
Because China created a network between world, created the network between the world sub corridor corridor something.
Okay, anything if
and China international relation is much better than India.
Okay, yeah.
Because China invested in many African countries and many East Asia, Indonesia something in the Indonesian countries, so many countries supported China.
Yes,
you are very right that international label China is not that much friendly, but reputation is also not good China. And if you talk about
politics, its politics is very, because China's economy is very high, 4 times from India. That's
yes,
China
yes.
Invested in poor countries.
Yes, you are right. Yes, Sanjeev, if you want to something 8 point, then add.
Hello.
Yes, Akash, you. Hello, Rajiv.
Hello.
You want to say something?
I am not hearing due to the Dasara Mela, so I am coming.
Okay. Now. No.
There is some.
Yes,
Rajiv, unmute yourself. I will give you chance later.
Hello.
Yes, Rajiv.
My topic is Asian superpower, India or China. I think that both are having superpowers. India has worse diversity, and as well as China has worse diversity. So I think that there are hub industries as well as China and India. If we are both combined, then we get super power all over Asia, and as we know that the more companies are shifting in India due to, and in coming years India is a first mobile developing country are happened after China is
okay.
And I think that the superpower countries like India is not going to developing, it is all developed. now they in few years there are very little companies are surviving, and now in the Noida side and Delhi and Great Noida, both are hub of industries, IT sector as well as many solars. Now very developing yojanas coming like green yojanas like solar panel are distributed all over Delhi as well as Greater Noida. So I think that superpower increase when all developed like as well as education and farmers also increase as well as companies increase and punctualities it must involve. So I think that China have now facing the problem of coal nowadays. In all the reserve coals are now in China. So China's companies are shifting in India. India is also facing, but now little recovered as compared to China. So China have now facing many problems like dam falling and flood are coming in those areas as well as electricity. So as compared to China, now India is more powerful nowadays as well as armies are more stronger, but equipment are less, I suppose, because now India is developing and before China is developed. So I think that superpower increases when education as well as farmers and all era sectors are developing. Thank you.
Thank you, Raju, for adding the point in this topic. So let's give the chance to everybody talked. Yeah, let's give the chance to Kanchan. Kanchan, unmute yourself and talk about the Asia superpower, China or India. What you think, Kanchan?
Yes, ma'am.
So you know the topic. You speak on the topic first. Whatever you feel, you can speak.
Yes, ma'am. The most topic is Asia superpower, India and China.
Yes.
The most powerful country in Asia are Japan and India. All over, they hold similar levels of power and both rank highly in their economics capability and cultural influence. South Asian countries sorry ma'am.
Okay, no problem, you just tried, that's okay. So
Kanchan, if you are speaking well, you can continue. Take time, but you continue.
Yeah, you are trying is a good it's appreciable. You tried. If person is trying, they will be succeed one day. So it's a very appreciable, you are speaking in the public place and you will speak one day, very good. So let's come out on second topic. How can technology help to improve the education? So who is interested, unmute yourself and talk on the topic. Let's see who is first speaking on this topic. How can technology help to improve the education? Anyone have idea? So let's come up with the second topic. Am I audible?
Yes,
you are audible.
Okay, let's welcoming the new member, Vijay. Like left, so no problem. So Raju, if you want to talk, then unmute yourself and talk on the topic.
How can technology help to improve education? I think that in the corona time, main development in improvement in education due to the technology. There are many technology are coming due to the digital development in IT sector and software engineering. So I think that the technology is minor role in the education. For example, in the corona time, many teachers are teach in the Zoom app and teach the students. And many other things like another apps in my school, Google Meet is used in teacher and they teach the student at the home. In the corona time, if we are not use the technology, then people are countries get 2 or 3 years back in GDP level is decreased and as well as knowledge is decreased. Technology help in every sector, like if we want to get digitally, then we use digital locker, then we reduce the papers. If we are not getting in technology, then we are facing always problem. There are too many sectors, like we know that in the cachery, there are mainly work as a paper. And paper will be not so much beneficial because tree is cutting and also having some problem to store at a place, proper place. And if we are use technology like online paper, like Google Space, so we can reduce the paper as well as store the long time it is on the server. So when we want to anywhere, we can fetch the data and we can see it. So I think that technology develops the countries. If we are more technologically good, then we more developed country. We know that the China is more developed due to their technology, because there was only technology in every sector. Like we are use Google Chrome, they use browser, we use Facebook, then we use something else, WeChat, like. So they made own technology and use it. And their own technology, so they get more GDP increases because all the money they get this technology, by technology, they earn their own countries, peoples. So they are more beneficial. And many apps like in the vaccine time we use the app, that app name is Ayushman Patani. So some apps are can. So they also direct the people who are corona affected and where the area corona is more affected. So many apps help people to know general knowledge, and many technology in every sector, like agriculture, if we want to learn, then we want to go YouTube, and YouTube also provide the many initial knowledge to know about this topic or that topic. So I think that technology is a gift to us, and it is always help in our life. Thank you.
Thank you, Raju. You added so many points, like technology is a help, is a gift for us. By technology, we reduce the amount of the paper we are using earlier, and digitally we can get every certificate in online form. Digital locker is available right now. So many technology helping us to reduce our daily effort, and you come up with a very good point, and it's a very appreciable. Let's give the chance to another person who will want to talk on the topic. So yeah, Divyansh, if you want to talk, please unmute on yourself.
How can technology help to improve education?
Yes.
I think in our today generation, technology is very important to everyone. And this is seen in the due to Corona time. And in the Corona time, every Indian parents need like a phone, which is given to his children to for study. And now it is not helplessness. It is a need for every parents to create a technology, and every parents knew about a technology like every other apps like in the other technologies. And I think in the today generation, technology improved day by day, and every Indian parents know this technology. And technology improve his technology improve in the area, not area in education, not education area, but every sorry.
You want to add any point, or is completed from you? I think. Okay, you added a good point that it's a need. It's a technology now generation become need. So that's a good point. If you want to any add something, or is completed from your side? I think 2 minutes you have, and I think you speak in only 1 minute. Every topic we have 3 minutes. So if you want to add something more, it will be good, I think. I think if you have any idea, anyways, so let's give this topic to the Akash. Please unmute yourself and speak on the topic. Am I audible, Akash? Kanchan, unmute yourself. Kanchan. Okay, so let's give the chance to the Sanjeev.
Hello.
Yes, Akash. Please come on the topic. How can technology help us to improve the education?
Technology helps in school curriculum. This will help students in increasing awareness about national and international events during the help of by social media or YouTube platform. Or it will help students by 3D models to much better understand the education, PPT, slide models, projector, from the projectors.
Hello, Akash. Rajiv, internet problem, baka.
You are audible.
No. Yes, yes, I'm not very so just. Yes, I can hear you.
Yes,
you are audible.
I think you I think you have completed. Yes?
Yes, I'm 2 points only. Technology can increase awareness, and it will help the student to better explain from the 3D models and objectives.
Yes, yes. Hello, Danjana.
1 minute, give me 1 minute.
Okay, I will, 1 or 2 points. And digital education. Digital education and digital learning helps increase the number of students, increase the awareness about the, increase the number of students. One person can increase their reach to other people by digital education.
Hello, now I am audible.
Yes,
yes,
you are.
Okay. Yeah, you are come up with very good point, Akash. You say that it helps national and international level. So that's very good point that you added in this meeting. That technology help in international level also. Yeah, Sanjeev, please talk on the topic.
Yes, thank you, Nana, for the giving the opportunity. On the topic, I have topic how technology help to improve education. Yes, we know that in this corona period, we only depends on technology. If we start from the beginning of the morning, we check our emails and the mobile phones, look out the mails, what are the going on, and begin our day. So if I talk about some 1 year before the all the cases which all have been dealt with, first we know that during one and a half period we suffered very hardly with this period, but this is a technology only which can, with the help of which, we can communicate with each other. In this period, we also suffer that isolation of a single person also. This how much difficult it is if someone is live for these 14 days alone. But thank God, a technology is so improved that even in the 14 days, 7 days, people are easily spent without it. Without much mental disorders, you know, 14 days if you someone have to live without any tools or the gadget, it becomes very harsh to spend there even single days. We see that whole the world are actually contract to two or more people, but it is a technology which can communicate everybody and try to connect the world also. So it is a power of technology which can come, which can help in the overcoming the period of the corona period. But if we talk about the broad aspect of the what are the technologies really are, let us start with the government focus on the digital technology. What are the digital technologies? Like we are using the payment website like the PhonePe, Bheem. All are the actually developed during this digitization period, which is only possible through the technology. We can easily payment to anybody and do our payment and easily solve all the payment related issues. Now the in the banks also a lot of the crowd in the past we have seen how much difficulties we have faced, but nowadays there is no queue in the bank also. Everybody and all the bank workers only happen in the mobile, and everybody feels very relaxed over the banking system. Now I'm take a move on the doing job. This is on this corona period, everybody, lots of the people who do job in the IT sector do her job very easily over the home also. but nobody see nobody think that they we can it can also be possible that everybody work from the home, but work from works for this technology. If this technology is not with us, then it will be not possible, and a lot more unemployment are there if this technology is not with us. But this technology also give us employment in this corona period. And if we talk about the shopping, we see that a lot of people are not going outside, but through their mobiles, they use the e-shop and they buy a lot of things. They have not need to move in the market to search a single thing over the lots of the shop. They search all the things over the mobile, spending some time. But one thing he or she buy, which can possible buy a single man. In this corona period, fewer more people are helping in the shopping list of all of the men. So this is a big factors which also help in this corona period. Up till I am talking about what the technology help in our corona period. But if we go in the future, so what will be the future with technology? Then I come up with this point that if you see that IT sectors are going more faster. So why this IT sector is moving so fast? The reason behind is that everything is connected with data, the big data source. This is only helping the everybody who doing jobs, works, and easy to do everything easy. Okay, so we see that in the building construction also, construction sector also, a lot of the automations are there. This is also the health, also a technology. In the aviation sector also, in the construction sector also, in the sector of the government, all this all the works are the documented digitization all there. In the future also, all the government facilities are provided over the mobiles. Nobody have to wander here and where. All the government facilities will be provided over the mobiles. The students get all his educational content over the mobile. And also the people will feel very relaxed with the technology gadgets for their daily works also. So we are actually spared with the a lot of the technology tools that will connect to us. But everything has the two factors. One is positive factor and second is negative factor. First, in the technology era, everything seems like positive, but in the future it will be not be positive. It has some negative aspect also. As we know that this technology are helping so much, but it is also true that this technology also distract us. Lots of the mental disorders are created due to this technology itself. If you talk about the 40 or 50 years before, nobody had the problem. But nowadays,
Rajmi, your voice cut kar raha hai. No, your voice is breaking. It's not audible. I think internet is who you have.
Okay. And now?
Yeah, now it's okay. Now it's okay.
Actually, I am talking about the negative aspect of this technology. I have already said that if we look back at the 40 or 50 years back, and that time the mental disorders are the less, and the people are it's directly connected with each other, not by the Facebook, Instagram, it's for lots of the platform. But actually they directly meet with each other and they solve the problem by talking to each other genuinely. But nowadays everything is happen over the technology. People are actually not connected with each other. A lot of people are the such a type of isolation they have they suffer that they actually if have genuine mental disorder, then they never tell with the, even with this family member. And a lot of the suicide cases were seen in this era. But if you talk in the 40 or 50 years before, such a type of the cases we cannot see, like the mental disorder, people doing suicide. These are not the cases as before. Nowadays, lots of the students and the boys are the suffer with the lots of the problem over this technology. They actually caught totally catch in the net of technology. You know, you see that lots of the games are the nowadays the boys are the students are the playing. That's make them unhealthy, and also they lose all its physical strength also. You know, students are the only busy over the mobiles and gadget. They are not doing physical activities. They didn't play any games, and even they spend the 5 or 10 minutes, even sometimes 6 or 7 hours over the single seat. And then they forget to moving or the wandering for the making a health good. But this type of the problem are seen over the technology. First is isolation of the guys and the students and sometimes elders, because also isolation is the first point. The second is that they are spending more and more time over the technology, and that is not good. That is a very injurious stuff for their health. So the balance between the technology and the real genuine life without the technology, they're not able to balance. And the time said that now it's time to become a balance to keep the balance between the technical part of our us and the non-technical part of us. So. I think every aspect of this technology I have told that.
Yes, it's okay. You come up with a very good point. Let me tell you what you said in this meeting. I think you talk about the payment system and work from home and all the. You already said that balance in technology is required because so many people are losing their physical strength due to they are sitting a lot of time in one seat and. I think you covered all the point. Even you talk about the stress level and digitalization, education, and also you talk about the technology, how we get used, like we got relaxed with a gadget nowadays. But sometimes it's also over of anything is a very bad. And also you come up with a very good example that so many students come with a game and they are doing the things. So all the point you expect all the aspect of this, I think you covered all the point. And I was expecting this thing come over this meeting as, and you come with all the expect. That's very appreciable. Let's give the chance to another person. So let's give the chance to Divyans. I think Divyans talked about that topic. Akash?
Yes, ma'am.
Akash already talked. Let me give the chance to the new person. Hi, Rajan. Ranjan, maybe. Ranjan Prajapati, if you are able to hear me, please unmute yourself and give little introduction yourself and come up with the second topic. How can technology help to improve the education?
Hello, Ranjan. Can you hear? Hello, Ranjan.
Okay, leave it. I think he is not able to hear us. So. I think everybody talked about that topic. Let's come on the third topic. Kanchan, if you want to speak, please unmute yourself.
Hello,
So like without further ado, let's give come on the third topic, because we have very less time. We already covered 47 minutes. So we are expecting 1 hour only for this. So let's come on the third topic. Fairness cream advertisement contribute to the racism. So let's give the chance to Rajiv. Rajiv, please unmute yourself and talk on the topic.
And what is the meaning of racism?
Racism is something that upper is sometimes there is a casteism, sometimes come under, which is not fair. Which is not fair. Let's come under that racism.
Hello.
Yeah, Rajiv, please explain what is racism and everything. Fairness cream. Okay.
Fairness cream advertisements contribute to racism. Firstly, I want to tell about the racism. When someone facing unfair way of treating people of different race, then we say to racism. Suppose two person are standing one place, then another people watching both people, then his mind are running that they people are black and another people are white. Then this term come in the mind like black and white, then it is said to be racism. And now I am coming in the point of fairness cream advertisement contributes to racism. I think that it is correct, but not totally correct. Then we know that the many actors or many advertisements that advertise the many beauty creams like Lakme and Fair Lovely and another thing that they advertise on the television, that it is not 100% good, because their own children who are advertising, their own children, they not giving that product to use them. So I think that if they are not giving their own children, then how can people that items can use their own self? So I think that many items like fair, handsome, sometimes controversial topic came in the fairness cream. Beauty are came when you use fairness, fair lovely. And this matter goes in high court, because one people are used and their face are not to go, goes to white, they are affecting due to the this cream, and he goes to high court as well as Supreme Court due to the written on the level of that this cream is 100% give you as a good product, then he claim it. Then he also give the revenue for this punishment are give to high court. I think that fairness cream advertisement are good as well as, but long effect is affecting our skin, and temporary it is good. If you want to go any ceremonies like party as well as marriage, then we are temporary usage as well as your face is glow, and we are enjoying the party, but it is not long term, because in the current we are using this product and we are also get 100% result, but it is also affecting the skin, and so many diseases are occur like your face get dull as well as some problems happen. So there are both, we can say that it is good as well as bad, but mostly in this topic came advertisement contribute to racism. So I think that this topic is good, because the racism are occur on the television they show that in previous I am that, and after I get that, that thing, then it is not 100% correct, because I think that their followers and who advertise, there are 100,000 or lakh followers. If he tell a lie, then people are also use them. And after he get wrong impact on our daily life, then he advertisers are also affected. Who advertisement, like some advertisement are done like Kareena Kapoor Lakme cream, as well as some others like Urvashi, another, and it also came in also news due to the controversial creams. They are more hygienic as well as some more effective our body. So I want to say that we can wanted to glow our face, then we can use our natural treatment like yoga help to give our more face growth as well as body goodness is increases if we done yoga as well as exercise. And some yogas are also in the face yogas and body, then we can also overcome this problem. And this may happen due to the different thinking of people, that they person that night used so much product of, and they came in this function. Then contribution, and then they think that they are alone in this party. Then he faced some racism. I think that, okay, this topic is not so much.
I think you covered all the point, whatever you know, and you come up with a very clear-cut information, like what is racism, unfair treating someone is called racism, and you come up with that point that beauty product is good for some extent, but every time the actor saying like that is very good and 100% fairness happen, but even their child is not using that product. So you come up with a very clear-cut example, and whatever you said is very informative, and let's give the chance to another person. So we will, and also you covered that point that face yoga, and that is if you want something glow or something, so they can do yoga also. So yoga is helpful for any disease, so you can take as yoga also for the face glowness something. So you come up with these points, let's give the chance to Shivangi. So Shivangi, if you are able to hear us, let's come on the topic. Fairness came in advertisement contribute to racism. What do you think?
Yes. So thank you for giving me opportunity. Okay. My name is Shivangi, and the topic is like a fair lovely and other fairness creams are rise to racism. Yes, I'm 98% support this topic. It is very genuine topic, because today we all are judged because of their in advertisement in TV. All the places we see the advertisement, and the high cost, and the cosmetic industry is just so much booming. But the reason behind that is not right, because it's a race to the racism. And people are suffering from that. It's not a good if a person is suffering from that. So we should not promote that. And if they want to sell their products, so they cannot use the sentiments of people and then try to say that if they are using their product, they can be like they got a job and got success, got their partner and happy family, happy life, everything. A cream doesn't give you everything, but confidence can give you everything. So I think we should ban these type of things where the racisms occur. If they want to sell their products, they can sell and tell that use this product and this can be helpful to you. In some 1 minute or 2 minute, they can give you happiness, but not they can give you happiness till your life and everything you can achieve from your cream and everything. So people are from that not so much rich that everybody can afford these type of thing. So they feel like not treated well sometimes if they are not using that, and feel like that other people treat like they are illiterate, they don't know everything how to do these type of uses, and they are promoting these more, and they treat you like that you don't know nothing if you're not using that thing. So I must say that we should stop these type of things, and we should increase the internal beauty, and we should always support to the internal beauty. I know that people will say that first interaction is like seeing the body and face, but we should not judge mental and think about that face beauty and everything is related to that. So racism arises from there when we see that person and think about the color of skin is everything. So these type of cream always support that. So we should not use that, and we should ban that in my case. So that's all what I want to say. Thank you,
Shivangi. You spoken very confidently, and that's very make your presentation very beautiful. And you say that you can achieve everything by your confidence, and that is very true. That it's a very obvious. If you have confidence, then you can achieve everything. And facial colors is not matter. You already say that first expression impression is everything. But sometimes you say that people are may thinking that by first expression, but that is not enough for that knowing the other personality. So it's very true that if that product is contributing only 1 or 2 hour happiness, not whole your life. So we have to know the what is reality, what is unrealistic thing. So thanks for your valuable time, Shivangi, and I'm hoping you will still continue this topic. We will stay connected with the till the last. Let's see what other person come out with this topic. So let's give the chance to the Sanjeev, and Sanjeev, please unmute yourself and talk on the topic.
Okay. Now we have a topic: the fairness cream advertisement contribute to the racism. I think it is not absolutely right, but it is right something, because the fairness not started from the advertisement. It has a long story. It has a long history also, because fairness creams are the usage at the time when the human civilization just started protecting themselves from the bright sun, and also from the lots of the disease comes over the history of the time. That's the start. The use of the creams and the others fair product are the beauty products. On that time, there is no media for the advertisement. But still, there on that time there was a there it's going on. So what we see behind in the history that the fairness is a type of things people actually do for the looking better, and also for the taking care of themselves, because skins are so sensitive, different geographical areas. So as the human generation are growing, they use the different types of the items, creams, and other beauty products. For the protecting from the lots of the water diseases and the sun some causes a lot of the disease over these skills. So that's protect them. This is a start about using the fair creams also. A lot of the beauty products. As in go to the South Korea, the South Korea nowadays are the hub of the beauty products and the a lot of the items of the sun care products and the body care products and the natural products also. But I am now just come to a point of the advertisement. Is this advertisement contribute to this racism? I think advertisement is associated with a lot of the products, not a single. We see that sometimes if the people's heights are not increasing, advertisement coming that the Complan, if we drink at the time of a teenager, then its height will be very good. But it is not actually true. Yes, somebody is taking a protein products, then it becomes too much muscles. But this is also not true. If someone take a beauty product cream, then it become fair. It is not true. This wrong information which we get from the advertisement, that is actually wrong. Yes, I can say that sometimes some fair creams also protect from the sun also. Some creams protect us from the some of the disease which comes over the screen. This is true. Then this type of advertisement, if there is, then there is no problem. If you talk about the point, racism. The racism comes with lookings of the human beings. It not be the way to people get some too much opportunity, and some people not get opportunity on the behalf of how he look, how he fair, how he looking smart. I think this is point. The people actually judge by the actually asking the some questions, looking their actual skills. How he talk, how he speak, how he actually get some skill to do job. These are the actual basis on which we can judge. And we also listen the word apartism in the Rangbhed, in the Hindi we say that, but is apartism we see in the America also, where the fair are the white people are the treated well, but the black people are the treated very badly. They black people actually not get us even a right for the enter in the cinema halls or enter in the some good places. This is problem with the racism actually.
I think
so. We cannot judge the advertisement judge contribute to racism. Actually, advertisement wrong advertisement contribute to the racism.
Okay, Sanjeev, I think you covered all the point. Let me, I want to add some point in your discussion. You said that white people is dominant over the black, that's why they are. So I think I want to add in this discussion. Racism is not about the white or black or advertisement or something. I think unfair treatment is like racism. Even though sometimes the black people are more and white people are less, at that time the black people are dominating over the fair screen, then they will be treating on their self very unusual. And I think it's not depend upon color, or it's depend on majority minority. There is a racism always occurred, like in India, the Hindu was more as compared to Muslim. So if there is an untreatment happen, then we is come under the racism also. So you covered all the point very well. So you come up with those good points. So let's, I think it's a very, already very time happened. Let's give the chance to another person also, and we will conclude this meeting, and we will hope we will see these people, whoever come in meeting, they will join next meeting also. So here is Ranjan Prajapati. So if you are able to hear me, so please unmute yourself and give a small introduction yourself. Hello. Ranjan Prajapati.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, Ranjan.
Ji, ji, bilkul. Can I speak in Hindi?
You try in English.
Good.
Yeah, Ranjan, you try in English. We will not judging you. Just you try. So just open platform, and people are helping you if you mistake. So introduce yourself. Tell me about yourself.
बोलूं अगर मैं हिंदी में बोलूं तो शायद मेरे लिए बहुत बेहतर रहेगा.
ओके ओके यू ट्राई. ओके ओके यू विल ट्राई. नो इशू.
हेलो रंजन, आई एम संजीव.
ओके
यू नो एक्चुअली दिस प्लेटफॉर्म इज क्रिएटेड फॉर द इंप्रूवमेंट ऑफ द इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. एक्चुअली हियर ऑल आर माय फ्रेंड्स आर देयर, दे आर जस्ट अ बिगिनर. So something a point if you have give is not important, but you have tried in your English language so that you can contribute your views over the world. I think we are the global person nowadays. So this is a platform for your improvement. If you something try here, then no one can be judging. But if you try in Hindi, then it's we know you actually. But you try here, that's important for me through this platform. Okay.
संजीव जी आपकी बातों से मैं बेहद खुश हूँ कि आपने जो है इम्प्रूवमेंट और ट्राई करने के लिए बातें कही है. ये बहुत अच्छी बात है. बट ये बहुत जरूरी नहीं है कि इंग्लिश बोल के ही हम अपने आप को बहुत ऊंचा बना सकते हैं.
Yes,
बुरा मत मानिएगा.
I interrupted you. Sorry.
नहीं है. संजीव जी आई एम सॉरी बट ट्राई टू स्पीक इन इंग्लिश. यू कैन से दैट दिस प्लेटफॉर्म इज द इम्प्रूवमेंट इन लैंग्वेज एंड एनी थिंग्स एनी साइट्स. तो बट आई एम ट्राई टू स्पीक इन इंग्लिश एंड ट्राई टू बेटर
Yes,
to work this language.
That's great.
Myself Ranjan Prajapati, or I am belongs to Kushinagar district, Uttar Pradesh state. I am in profession is the Ayurveda, that means direct selling business.
Wow, that's great.
Or main jo hai speak in technology.
ओके
टेक्नोलॉजी पे मैं बात करना चाहूंगा. और टेक्नोलॉजी इज द इससे में जो हमारी टेक्नोलॉजी है वो काफी जो है हमारे लिए स्पून कर सकते हैं, वरदान कर सकते हैं, वरदान के रूप में है. बट इज द ड्रॉबैक माय यूथ पर्संस बिकॉज एनी टाइप ऑफ गेम्स लाइक पबजी फायर ऐसा कुछ करके और कोई गेम आ रहा है फायर कुछ करके आई नेम नॉट क्लियर. तो माई यूथ या ये कह सकते हैं कि हमारे जो नए युवक हैं, जो नए बच्चे हैं, जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं, वो जो है इस टेक्नोलॉजी के वजह से जो है गेम में काफ़ी अपने टाइम को वेस्ट करते रहे. तो ये टेक्नोलॉजी हमारे लिए बेटर है बट एक जो दूसरी दृष्टि से देखा जाए तो काफ़ी जो है नुकसान भी पहुंचा रही है. अभी हाल ही में हम लोगों ने बहुत सारे न्यूज़ देखते हैं कि इस टेक्नोलॉजी की वजह से गेम को प्ले करने की वजह से काफ़ी जो है बच्चे जो है डिप्रेशन के शिकार भी हो रहे हैं। तो ये टॉपिक पे आपने जैसे संजीव जी ने बताया कि डिप्रेशन है, या फिर एक चीज और उन्होंने बताया कि जो नई टेक्नोलॉजी जो आई है और उस टेक्नोलॉजी में एपीएस सिस्टम जो बैंक सिस्टम ने लेके आया है आरबीआई ने, उसमें जो है क्यू में आने की कोई रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है, बहुत जो है हर जगह जो है पैसे को आसानी से रिसीव किया जा सकता है, मनी को ड्रॉबैक या कहीं डिपॉजिट किया जा सकता है, ये सब बहुत अच्छी बात है। लेकिन एक इसके पीछे हमारी ड्रॉबैक ये है जिसपे मेरा मोटो है, और उस मोटो पे ये अगर इस चीज़ को काफ़ी ध्यान दिया जाए कि इस टेक्नोलॉजी में जैसे गेम है, टेलीविजन से काफ़ी जो है बच्चे हमारे टेलीविजन से भी समय को वेस्ट कर रहे हैं। और एक चीज़ और, टेक्नोलॉजी से सीखने के लिए बहुत सारी चीज़ अच्छी चीज़ें मिल रही हैं, और हमने भी अपने कोई इम्प्रूवमेंट किया है, या डायरेक्ट सेलिंग बिजनेस की जो भी स्टडी है, ये डायरेक्ट सेलिंग बिजनेस को मैंने यूट्यूब के बिहाफ ही, या कह सकते हैं यूट्यूब के प्लेटफॉर्म से ही हमने लर्निंग शुरू किया था। तो टेक्नोलॉजी बेहतर है, और फिर आगे जो है आप सभी का जो कहना है बताएं।
Okay.
That's a good Ranjan. But next time you try to give your content in small, it's okay. But you try in the English. But this will open your international platform for your selling of the product also. But also in India also, it's connect the lots of the people with you directly, and the people also build confidence with you. With this selling partner, and also you become a good businessman in the future, I hope, and best of luck for you.
Hi Ranjan, you spoke very well, but I will appreciate more when you speak a little bit in English also, because here people are sometimes come from another country, so they will be not understand Hindi, and some people come from us. So that's why we make that platform for world level. Today maybe people are not joined much, but earlier people are come from another country too, and my aim to build this platform for connection from the international level. So here people, if you talk about mother tongue, I'm also very good speaker in Hindi. All the participants know in Hindi very well, but our motto is to connect with the global level, and we will whatever do business in a global level, it will be more impact. And Indian is our brother, but international level brother, but international level, if you dominate, then it will be wonderful. So it's like a butter on the cherry. In the butter on the cherry, if you have butter, it's okay. We know the Hindi, it's a butter. But there is cherry, so it will be wonderful. So I know you know in English very well, because in your conversation I go through the, you use very different word like drawbacks, time waster. So I know that you know English. So I want to appreciate more when you speak in English, so my participants also know that English from you. And I know you have all the clarity to speak in English, so because my aim is to connect with the world level.
Okay. I also try next time and speak in English and improvement to self.
Okay, that's great. That's the spirit of a great seller, I think. Even you know that so many businessmen speak in English. Why? Because want to connect to international level. So just start follow with a person who know the better English in a sales department, and then we will speak very you improve very fast. It's my opinion. That's why I share to you, like if you want to become more international level seller, then you connect with some international talk person which is related to sales, so your English also increase and your knowledge also will increase. So I want to say that you also connect next day, and nobody judge you. Even I am not good in English, that's why I'm making that group, so together we learn.
I understand.
Okay, that's great. I think it's time to conclude this meeting, and if you want any topic more, he has three more options, so okay,
you want Ranjana ji?
Yes, yeah, tell me in English only, please try in English.
Ji bilkul. Sanjeev is my friend's classmate in the engineering college.
Okay, that's great.
After three semester, I can drop down college and back to home. Suddenly, Sanjeev to send a WhatsApp message this meeting.
Okay.
But I do not understand what the purpose of this meeting.
Okay.
But also try to join a meeting, and she hear that this in this meeting improvement contribution advertisement contribute, and technology help to improve how education. So I can join this meeting.
Okay.
And
I think you know, you have very good knowledge. You spoke, I covered so many points from your discussion, and you have very good knowledge. You learned from the YouTube so many things you already said, and you tell about the advantage, disadvantage, how the people are wasting the time in PUBG. So many things you spoke in a very less time. So you have the all the thing, and you joined by the link, and that's very good, because the person, you have very confidence, because you join unknown group without knowing much. So that's so that you have the very good confidence. So I'm hoping you will become the world level seller, and that's a point from my side. That
I have no idea what is this type of link and what is this the this type of meeting, but my friend Sanjeev sent the WhatsApp link. I told and believe on this Sanjeev.
Thanks, Sanjeev.
See the message or.
Hello.
And I just joined the meeting.
Okay. Hello?
Thanks, Ranjan, for the belief in me.
Okay.
Actually, I connect to you because I know you. You are also interested in the talk with the some genuine points. So I give you link. I know that you will be joined, and you would also join also. I think. We discuss daily on the 9 to 10 p.m. So you can, if you have a time, then you join daily. It will be also helpful for us also and you also.
Because from your discussion, I got so many points, and I think you are a selling person, so you have very good knowledge, so we can learn from you. I think once upon Abdul Kalam said that one friend, good friend is equal to 200 library. So for sale, if I want to learn the marketing, I have to read all the book, but you have already the marketing knowledge, then I will learn very quick. So it will be very appreciable when you continue with us.
Okay, thank you.
Now I should bind it.
Okay, it's time to bind up the meeting, and every day 9 to 10 we will meet in same link, you can join. Thanks Ranjanji, and thanks Anju.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night, Ranjana ji, and good night, my friends, my dear friends, Sanjeev ji.
Okay.
Thank you. लगा सके तो पता नहीं कि स्टाफ के वाला हमको तो पता ही चल जाला।